Greetings and welcome, my comrades, to another episode of Let's Play Earth 2150.
What?
Okay, and let's explore the Ural Mountains. I'll say the pathing is a little bit less dumb for the units than it is in Dark Reign 2. Ooh, message from headquarters. Unidentified vehicles discovered in this region have no right to be here. They pose a threat to our outpost. Open fire and neutralize these unknown intruders. The SA chairman has given you permission to construct a refinery. This will supply the credits for use in this mission area and enable you to build units and expand the outpost. Signed, Captain Dmitry Krutov, Supply Administration, Department of Procurement. Oh, nice. Alright, so
yes,
apparently I saw.
Down the middle and up yours.
So we did see the enemy. Oh, there it is. Now these are just a couple of lunars. They are so dramatic when they're getting hit. Now I'm not too scared of these lunars because they are frankly not much of a threat. Let's fall back to the base. So we do now have permission to build some other buildings. Let's start with a refinery first. That might be more useful. Can fit it in somewhere.
Yeah.
That will do. And I have also access to the Irkutsk. I'll give it a chain gun. We're not going underwater, but we might want to have something available. Can't really do anything else. I can just build more stuff. Thousands, and now it's gonna summon in a helicopter and bring it over.
What do you want?
And fine. Also get a supply depot.
As you wish, comrade.
Because our troops are using ammunition weapons and they might run out eventually. Alright, you go to base, don't need you to be in potential danger. Alright, let's get a vehicle production center and a weapons production center. Now, what I do appreciate about these buildings is that you can actually give them weapons. In defense. Which makes a lot of sense. Why wouldn't you put just random guns on your buildings? Well, it's not totally random, but it does mean you don't have to rely too much on static weapons that are too easily blown up. Your base can hold its own for a brief while. Obviously, you don't want to be totally reliant on it. That we need more power, production building.
As you wish, comrade.
Right, there's a key for a power grid.
Of course.
while we're waiting for that, let's get a couple of boyars. Whoops. Just two of them would be fine. Boyars are our supply helicopters. They will keep our boys with the ammo they need. You don't need to produce ammo, luckily.
Production completed. Production started.
Low on materials.
Yeah. Alright, let's have you drop off at the refinery. Now the goal has not changed much, but we do need to destroy all enemy units. And the quicker we can do that, the more easily we can take advantage of enemies' position, because we can just steal their supplies. That's the second boyar. It should be more than enough. Alright, let's fill in our squad. Let's set the destination point for over here. We've got five tanks. Let's
production started.
Build another five and a couple of tigers to just help out. And I don't think anything has been unlocked weapons wise. I want to do, I could bring over some money from here to the mission, but don't feel like doing that either. Oh, look at that, we got something heading for space.
Production completed. Production started.
And I should be able to blitz over the enemy in this case, because for the most part they just have some lunars and whatever base defense they have, of course, which shouldn't really be able to stand up too much against our Pamias. But it will not remain at that. So yeah, our first opponent is the Lunar Corporation, which is kinda unique. You'd expect to be going up against the UCS, and we will be going up against the UCS. A lot. But I am not too scared of either one at the moment yet. If not really getting gotten into any of the terrifying weapons, and at the moment my Pamirs are more than a match for whatever the enemy is throwing at me, because for the most part they are just got some light units with some minor weapons like machine guns, which the Pamirs can easily absorb with their fairly high armor rating. I mean, they have not quite as many hit points as even the Tigers, but they do have a lot of armor protection. Should do more than enough. The only thing they don't really have is firepower. They're just the 105mm cannon. Which sounds like a lot. It's okay.
Production completed.
But I kind of do want to have an overwhelming force before I move in. Hopefully not give the enemy too much time to prepare, because we will be losing some tanks, because I don't have any way to repair my vehicles. In one significant way that this game actually differs from the previous game in the sequence, is that it doesn't have any infantry. Which I guess they kind of figured that infantry was just a little bit too awkward to animate and use on the field of battle. Which, considering the infantry of Dark Reign 2, yeah, I think that was probably a wise decision. Vehicles are much easier to animate, probably.
Production
or at least to give pathing. Just testing the what the buttons do. Because I don't remember. We don't have any tunnels, so there's no point in looking there, but yep, we have tunnel systems in this game as well. Kinda make me miss Metal Fatigue back in the day. Even though I had only played the demo of Metal Fatigue.
Production completed.
Alright, the premieres are done.
Production started.
So we have our upgraded ones as well as our old ones, but they're functionally pretty much the same.
What now?
I think the upgraded ones have maybe a little bit more HP.
On the move.
Their frame looks a little bit different, I think. Right, so as soon as we have some of our tigers on the field, we can go.
Production completed. Production started.
And we still have some money left. Don't want to give too much away because we will also need to bring it back to base because we don't want to leave any money behind.
Production completed. Production started. Production completed. Production started.
Right, one more. Yes. And we'll sit you back to delivering to the main base. I don't think we need much more.
Right away, comrade. Production completed.
All right, there we go. The good thing these vehicles don't need any fuel or anything.
Nostravia. What?
Alright, let's go and look for some lunatics. Lunar people.
What on the move? Okay, comrade. What now? What?
Or we go that way.
Right away.
Bathing is fairly good.
Right away.
It's not brilliant, but it does the job. Most of my units will not get lost or stuck.
Right away.
But they do always seem to know the path before I do, so
okay,
there's that.
Yes. On the move.
This game is eerily quiet when the music is not playing.
Yes, Commander. Hey! On our way. What now? On our way.
At 12. I think we can go further this way then. Not here.
Yes. Okay, comrade.
Hey!
Yes, Commander. Here they come.
Ah, there we are. Some more lunars.
Hurrah, hurrah! Fire! I'm in! I love it, comrade!
Yeah, lunars are not really an opponent here. They're just light vehicles. Meant for mostly scouting purposes and light combat. You wouldn't really put them into action against anything heavier than the equivalent of a lunar. I don't know if they have access to anything bigger than that. Right. Here we have the enemy base. So they do have some... The structures which you have discovered have been identified as extraction mines. These bandits are stealing our mineral resources. Put a stop to this and raise the unlawful base to the ground.
Ah!
Right, so they do have slightly heavier vehicles. Which, you know, be expected. Let's hold back a bit. That's the one thing the people here have is technology. I'm still using guns and machine guns. They are using rockets. And they are very good at it.
Glory to the motherland. What now?
So now I need to put a stop to it. Just trying to blow up their power buildings.
New territory has been located.
Alright, that should reduce their defensive capability a bit. Essentially, my tanks have run out of ammo, so they need to be resupplied. And without power, their buildings cannot shoot back. So hopefully they cannot reclaim that, but it looks like they've managed to finish mining out this area. Did I lose both pointers? Did lose one, at the least.
Production started. Resource field exploited.
What?
Production completed.
Well, that's it then. Did we get a goal? Yes, we sent out more than we needed. And now I just need some more supplies.
I see a baby. What? Of course.
This is gonna take a while if they keep resupplying my tigers over my pamirs. Although they probably will give up once I blow up their main buildings. Yeah.
What?
Hello, comrade.
Well, we'll continue this next time, so. Thank you all for watching. See you then.